Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. I'm here with my Dominar UG at Autologue today, and we're gonna get some accessories installed. So we have Navinder and his team preparing my bike. Here's their latest set of accessories from Autologue. So this is the bashplate that is going to go on my bike. So it is going to be an installation come display video for all the latest accessories that Autologue is selling for Dominar. So starting with the bashplate, this is the bashplate, and here's the saddle stay set. It's been pre-assembled. Okay. Then we have the top rack. So this rear part is the top rack, and we have the backrest too. So all these four are going to go on my bike, and I'm going to be showing you the installation process too. So mainly this video is, I cannot say it's a giveaway, but all those who are interested in these four accessories from Autologue, the current price is somewhere around 12,000 something, and it's available at 20% discount if you purchase through them. But if you purchase through me, via me, you're going to get a very, very, very special price. You're going to get this set at 8,000 rupees approximately, all these four items. Now, how to purchase and all, I'll be putting that in the video description, and you can get in touch with me for purchasing. The price, what I told you, 8,000 is for Pune pickup from Autologue. If you're from outside from Pune, like from Mumbai or any other state, these can be shipped to you at a little additional cost, which I will get with from Autologue and then let you know. Few of the parts are in stock and they are ready delivery, and few of the parts might take a bit longer. So all these details of delivery etc. will be in the description of the video. So once we proceed now, these guys are proceeding with the installation. You have to remove the rear grab rails first. Okay, remove both the grab rails. Second grab rail also is being removed. So before you install anything below, you need to put the spacer plates below. You'll get two of these spacer plates along with the installation. So the spacer plates need to go down here. Now this is pre-assembled. Okay, we're going to be just placing this on the bike. You can install it one by one too, if you are not comfortable doing it, doing the pre-installation, the pre-clubbing. You can put the bracket first, this bracket first, then you can put the top rack and then the saddle stays and all. Okay, so this is how everything goes in. So you're using the same stock bolts that come from Bajaj that you had taken off from the grab rail. So you're going to use the same bolts to install the backrest, the top rack and the saddle stay mounts. Now installing the side bolts for top rack. So the top rack is mounted from the base plate of the top rack. Has two bolts here that you need to fix. Okay, two bolts here, two here, two here. So in all there are eight bolts that you need to fit from top, and lock nuts, Nilo lock nuts. Once these are installed, the pipes that come from top to bottom, they come out here and they lock in with the saddle space. So I'll advise one thing, those who are planning to purchase the stuff, you can purchase the backrest individually, but the top rack you will need to purchase with the saddle stay, and it will be a good that you purchase this set together, the saddle stay and the top rack, and of course the battles bash plate can be purchased individually. So the other side of the saddle stay also being tightened. Really compact saddle stays, I have not seen such compact ones so far. See if it's really inside. Won't, when I'm not touring on the bike, they won't be a hindrance in the parking and all. In finishing touches, tightening everything, and then you're going to start also with the bash plate. So for bash plate, you need to remove four bolts first, stock bolts, which is both on this side, there will be one here, and there'll be a second one out here, and there'll be two in the front, which is at this place. Now I guess one has already fallen off, so this must be rattling. I was experiencing rattle sounds, and second bolt is here. So total four bolts need to be taken off to take the current plastic bash plate off, or the belly off. So to install the bash plate, you need to install this bracket, and to install this bracket, you need to first take off the chain cover, and then remove this bolt out here. So we're removing that bolt just to, you know, for the ease of tightening the bolt from top. Otherwise you need not remove this cover. So it's going to take 2 minutes to remove the cover and then install the bracket. So once that cover is removed, see, this becomes easier for us to remove that bolt. Use a ratchet with a extension and then you'll be able to remove it easily. So that bolt has been removed and Allen bolt now fixed along with the bracket. So the second bracket, you need to utilize this hole, okay, over here. You need to pass the bolt from there. Irfan will now pass it. So you pass from there and tighten the bolt from other side. Now do this when the bike is completely cold, because there are chances that you might, you know, hand might touch the silencer and all. So for bash plate, you need to add these spacers you'll get along. Okay, the spacers you need to add to that part, along with the bolt. Let me show it to you from this side and a little bit from this side. So like this, one spacer and bolt goes in, and once that is in place, then you mount the bottom bolts for the rear part. So this side spacer is also put in place. Don't tighten it completely till all the nuts and bolts are in place. Now this one is going to go in place. Third one is also in place, and now the final bolt going in place. And the bash plate is almost installed. Nut is added from the back side. So all installations are done now, and I took a small test ride too. Everything looks good and no rattling or any such sound. So here's to begin with the bash plate first. That's a gypsy at the background. That one and Mukul is coming out. So here's the looks for bash plate. I'll be adding pictures also at the end of this video, so you guys can have a look at that also easily as a slideshow. And here's the backrest that is fitting nicely. And sitting nicely, fitting and sitting nicely. Okay, top rack. The top rack you've seen multiple times. Not much design has changed in it. And so the saddle stays. They're quite in line with the bike, not coming outside much. Okay. Sorry for the earlier part of the video where there was a lot of background noise. So right now all work has been stopped. Just for that, I can shoot it once. So you guys first need to install the remove the grab rails from the bottom of the seat. Okay, once the grab rails are removed, put the spacer plates, then put the mounts for top rack and saddle stay. Once the mount is installed, you can also put the backrest and use stock bolts. Then install the saddle stay, top rack, multiple bolts are there, and then your bike is ready. So watch the complete video and from the beginning, and if you have any questions regarding these, do let me know in the comments below and I'll try to answer them at the earliest. Regarding pricing, the set of four things: the bash plate, the saddle stays, the top rack and the backrest. If you buy these four things together, you're going to get it at 8,000 from me. Okay, it's going to be delivered by Autologue. If you're in Pune or Mumbai and you plan to come at Autologue and get it installed, there won't be any courier charges. But if you want the shipping to be done to your place, if you buy any of the two products, shipping is going to be $500. If you're buying three products, shipping is going to be $1,000. If you're buying four products, shipping is going to be $1,500 for all four. The price is 8,000 as I told you. And I'll add you guys, you can ping me on my Instagram. I'll leave my link in the description below. You can DM me on my Instagram and then we can get in touch via Instagram. I can add you to a WhatsApp group and you can fill in all the details where the product needs to be shipped. You can make the payment to me. I'll pass that on to Autologue and then you guys can get the delivery within 7 to 8, 10 days all over India, depending on where in India you are located and how much products you have purchased, how many products you have ordered. Okay. So apart from this, if you have any questions, please put them in the comments below. I leave link to Autologue also, Autologue's Instagram. So if you want to get in touch with them directly, you can do that too. So thanks for watching. This is Dipen from Pune at Autologue.